So we start our next topic, that is pharmacokinetic. So basically, what is pharmacokinetic? So pharmaco, they are combined to form two words. That is first pharmaco and second will be the kinetic. So what is pharmaco? Pharmaco word, which is derived from the Greek word pharmakon, which is meaning that is drug, and kinetics, which is derived from the Greek word that is kinetikos, which is moving. So this pharmacokinetic, which is defined as the this kinetic of the drug absorption, distribution, metabolism and excretion, that is ADME, and their relationship with pharmacological response or therapeutic or toxicological response in human being and the animals. So what is pharmacokinetic? It is a study of this ADME and their relationship between this with pharmacological response, toxicological response or therapeutic response in human being and animal. So the definition of this pharmacokinetics, it is defined as the kinetics of the drug absorption, distribution, metabolism, excretion, that is ADME, and their relationship with pharmacological, therapeutic or toxicological response in human and animal. So there are two aspects of pharmacokinetic studies. So first aspect is theoretical aspect, second will be the experimental aspect. So in theoretical aspect, which involves development of this pharmacokinetic model to predict the drug deposition after its administration, and the statistical method, which is applied, commonly applied, which interpret data and assess the various parameters in this theoretical aspect. Second aspect, that is experimental. So in this aspect, which involves development of biological sample techniques, analytical method for measurement of the drug concentration in biological samples, and data collection and their evaluation. So in the second aspect, that is experimental aspect. Next point, that is plasma drug concentration time profile. So there is a direct relationship which is exists between the concentration of drug at this biophase, that is site of action, and concentration of drug in the plasma. So there is a direct relationship between the concentration of the drug at these two phases, biophases, that biophase, that is site of action, and the second will be the concentration of the drug into the plasma. So there are two categories of parameter which are evaluated from this plasma concentration time profile. So this is the plasma concentration time profile, time versus plasma drug concentration. So this time profile, which are categorized into two parameters, first pharmacokinetic parameter and second will be the pharmacodynamic parameter. So in this first, the pharmacokinetic parameter. In the pharmacokinetic parameters, they are involved, they are divided into major three parameters. First parameter, that is peak plasma concentration, which is called as a Cmax. Second, time of peak concentration, Tmax, or which is also called as the ultimate time peak concentration. And third will be the area under the curve. So these are the pharmacokinetic parameters. Second, pharmacodynamic parameter. Second category, that is pharmacodynamic parameter. So in this first, minimum effective concentration, that is MEC. Second parameter in the pharmacodynamic, that is maximum safe concentration, that is MSC. Next, onset of action. Next, onset of time. Next will be the duration of action. Sixth will be the intensity of action. Seventh will be the therapeutic range. And last will be the therapeutic index. So first category, that is pharmacokinetic parameter in this peak plasma concentration. So this is the point at which there will be the concentration of drug which we have, or which is called as a peak plasma concentration. So this peak plasma concentration, or which is called as a point of maximum concentration of drug into the plasma, which is called as a peak. So this point which is called as the maximum concentration, the point at which maximum concentration of drug in the plasma and the concentration of the drug at this peak, which is known as a peak plasma concentration. So the point the drug concentration in the plasma will be maximum, which is called as a peak. And the concentration of drug at this peak and concentration of the drug at this peak, which is called as a peak plasma concentration. Also it is called as a peak height concentration or maximum drug concentration. So this peak plasma concentration, which is also known as a peak height concentration or maximum drug concentration. So this peak plasma concentration, or which is called as a Cmax, which is expressed in microgram per ml. So this is the peak plasma concentration, which has unit that is microgram per ml. This peak plasma, which levels, which is depend upon first, this peak plasma concentration, which is depend upon mainly dose administered, rate of absorption and rate of elimination. So this plasma level, peak plasma level, which is depend upon three factors, that is dose administered, second rate of absorption, and say third will be the rate of elimination. The peak represent point of the time which absorption rate which equal to elimination rate of the drug. So this peak, which is represent the point of time when absorption rate which is equal to the elimination rate. The left side of the peak of the curve, this plasma drug concentration time curve, on this left side, this side, so we showed which represent called as the absorption phase, where the rate of absorption is greater than, where rate of absorption is greater than rate of elimination. And the right side, and this side, which is called this right side, which is represent or which represent elimination phase, that when the rate of elimination which is exceed rate of absorption. So this peak concentration is related to the intensity of the pharmacological response. So this peak concentration, which is related to the pharmacological response, so this is a response above, and it should be ideal, this pharmacological response, which is ideal above this minimum effective concentration. It is ideal to this, above this minimum, this effective concentration, and but it is less than maximum safe concentration. So the pharmacological or peak concentration, which is related to this intensity of this pharmacological response, and it should be ideal above this minimum effective concentration and below this minimum safe concentration. Next parameter, pharmacokinetic parameter, which is called as the Tmax, or which is time of peak concentration. So what is time of peak concentration? The time for the drug which reaches peak concentration in plasma, peak concentration in the plasma after extravascular administration, which is called as the time of peak plasma concentration, which are expressed, or unit of this time of peak concentration, that is in hours, and which is useful in the estimation of this rate of absorption. The onset of time and onset of action are depending upon the onset of time and onset of action which depend upon this Tmax, that is time of peak concentration. This parameter, which is particularly important in the assessing the efficacy of the drug used in treatment of acute condition like, so this parameter, which is very useful in the assessing the efficacy of the drug which are used to treat acute condition like pain or insomnia, where the dose will be given, or this condition will be treated with single dose with the drug, or this condition, or in this condition the drug will be given in a single dose. So this is the second parameter, that is peak plasma, time of peak plasma concentration. Next parameter, that is area under the curve. So this total, so this is called as a area under the curve. So which represent the total integrated area under the plasma level time profile, and which express the total amount of the drug which are come into the systemic circulation after administration. So this is a total integrated area which are under into the plasma drug concentration time profile, and which express the total amount of the drug which express total amount of the drug which are come into the systemic circulation after administration. So this AUC express, that is unit of this AUC, that is area under the curve, that is microgram per ml into hours. So this AUC formula, AUC express, that unit will be the microgram per ml into hours. So it is most important parameter, this AUC or area under curve, which is most important parameter in evaluating bioavailability of the drug from its dosage form, and it will be represent the extent of absorption. So in the last chapter we study this area under the curve, which is very helpful, which is important for the evaluating this bioavailability of the drug from its dosage form, and also it will be represent the extent of absorption. This area under the curve is also important for the drugs which are administered repeatedly for the treatment of chronic condition. This AUC, which is helpful or important for the drug which are repeatedly administered into the chronic condition like asthma and the epilepsy. So what is area under the curve? The total integrated area under the plasma drug concentration time profile, which are expressed in the microgram per ml into hours. So this is a unit of this area under the curve, and which will be represent this, or this will be this important for the evaluation of this bioavailability of the drug from its dosage form, and also it will be represent the extent of absorption. So these are the pharmacokinetic parameters in the plasma drug concentration time profile. Next will be the parameters, pharmacodynamic parameters. So in this first parameter, that is minimum effective concentration. So this is pharmacodynamic parameters. So first parameter, that is minimum effective concentration. So minimum effective concentration, it is defined as a minimum Next parameter, that is pharmacodynamic parameter. So in these parameters, they are important. First parameter, that is minimum effective concentration. So what is minimum effective concentration? The concentration of the minimum concentration of the drug into the plasma, which produce therapeutic effect, which is called as a minimum effective concentration. So this reflects the minimum concentration of the drug at receptor site, which produce desired pharmacological responses. The concentration below this minimum effective concentration, the concentration of the drug below its minimum concentration, is said to be, which is called as a इफ द ड्रग समजा जर एखाद्या ड्रगचं कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन मिनिमम इफ्यूटी कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन कमी असेल विच इज कॉल्ड एज अ सब थेरापेटिक लेवल विच इज कॉल्ड एज अ सो दिस कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन ऑन ड्रग ऍट दिस पोझिशन विच इज कॉल्ड एज अ बिलो दिस मिनिमम इफेक्टिव्ह कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन विच इज कॉल्ड एज अ सब थेरापेटिक लेवल इन केस ऑफ अँटीबायोटिक द मिनिमम इनहिबिटरी कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन दॅट इज MIC इज यूज सो फॉर अँटीबायोटिक दॅट इज द टर्म यूज मिनिमम इनहिबिटरी कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन सो विच इज डिस्क्राइब एज मिनिमम कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन ऑफ अँटीबायोटिक्स इन प्लाज्मा विच इज रिक्वायर्ड टू किल ऑर इनहिबिट द ग्रोथ ऑफ मायक्रो ऑर्गॅनिझम सो this minimum inhibitory concentration which known as or defined as the minimum concentration of this antibiotic which kill this bacteria or kill this bacteria or the microorganism or which will be kill or inhibit the growth of microorganism in the minimum concentration of this antibiotic which is called as a minimum inhibitory concentration next factors or next next parameters of this pharmacodynamic that is minimum safe concentration so minimum minimum safe concentration same concentration or which is called as a maximum safe concentration so the concentration of the drug into the plasma above this above which adverse or unwanted effects are precipitated so above this minimum safe concentration above this minimum concentration of a drug into the plasma which shows adverse effect or unwanted effects and concentration of the drug above this minimum safe concentration which is called as or this layer which is called as a toxic level so ha minimum concentration safe concentration peksha जर एखाद्या ड्रगचं कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन प्लाझ्मामध्ये जास्त असेल विच इज कॉल्ड एज अ टॉक्सिक लेवल कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट टू पॅरामीटर्स मिनिमम इफेक्टिव्ह पॅरामीटर्स फार्माकोडायनामिक दॅट इज मिनिमम इफेक्टिव्ह कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन अँड सेकंड विल बी द मिनिमम सेफ कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन नेक्स्ट पॅरामीटर दॅट इज ऑनसेट ऑफ ऍक्शन सो दिस इज अ this at this this position of onset of action that is in the plasma concentration time profile so the beginning of pharmacological response which is called as the onset of action so we know the concentration when the concentration of the drug when concentration of the drug above this minimum concentration which shows therapeutic effect so this is onset of action is the beginning of the pharmacological response which is called as a onset of action and it will be occurs when the concentration of the drug in the plasma which exceeds this minimum effective concentration or above this minimum effective concentration next onset of time so it is the time required for the drug it is the time required for the drug or drugs to start to producing pharmacological response so first onset of action will be the it is a beginning of pharmacological response which is called as a onset of action and onset of time is a time required for the drug which will be start its pharmacological producing or produce pharmacological response which is called as a onset of time it is correspondent to the time for the plasma concentration which reach it is correspond to plasma concentration to reach minimum effective concentration after administration of the drug so it will be related to the time which is required for the plasma concentration of drug which reaches to this minimum effective concentration after any administration of the drug so this is the onset of time next point that is duration of the action so next parameter that is duration of action the time period for which the plasma concentration of the drug which remains the above minimum effective concentration which is called as the duration of action so what is duration of action so time of period the time of period for which this plasma concentration will be remain, this plasma concentration will of the drug will be remain above this minimum effective concentration, which is called as a plasma drug concentration. Next point, that is intensity of action. Next parameter, that is intensity of action. Intensity of action, which is defined as, it is the maximum pharmacological response produced by the peak plasma of the drug. So at this peak plasma concentration, the drug shows maximum pharmacological response will be produced by this peak plasma concentration of the drug, which is called as the intensity of action. So it is the maximum pharmacological response at peak plasma concentration, which is called as the intensity of action, and this also called as a peak response. This intensity of action, which is also known as a peak response. Next parameters, pharmacodynamic parameter, that is therapeutic range. Next parameter, that is therapeutic range. So the drug concentration between minimum effective concentration and minimum safe concentration, or which is called as a maximum safe concentration, which is called as a therapeutic range. So in this the concentration of drug in between both this minimum safe concentration and the minimum effective concentration, which is called as the therapeutic range, or which is also known as a therapeutic window. So this concentration, or the concentration of drug in between both MSC or MEC, which is called as a therapeutic window. Next pharmacodynamic parameter, that is therapeutic index. So what is therapeutic index? It is the ratio of minimum safe concentration to the maximum effective concentration, which is called as a therapeutic. So this is the ratio of these both, minimum safe concentration and minimum effective concentration, which is called as a therapeutic index. So it is also known as the ratio of dose required to produce toxic or lethal effect. So another definition, that is the dose, that is the ratio of dose required to produce toxic or lethal effect to the dose required to produce therapeutic effect. So it is a ratio of therapeutic index is a ratio of dose required to produce toxic or adverse effect or lethal effect to the dose required to produce therapeutic effect. So this is a pharmacodynamic parameters in the plasma drug concentration time profile. So first, in the pharmacokinetic parameter, that is peak plasma concentration, time of peak concentration. Next will be the area under the curve. And the pharmacodynamic parameters, first, that is minimum effective concentration, minimum safe concentration, onset of action, onset of time, duration of action, intensity of action, therapeutic range, and the last will be the therapeutic index. So these are the parameters of this pharmacodynamic parameters of the plasma drug time profile. So we stop here. Next point will be continuing to the next lecture.